They're being delivered into the United States. They're gang members. And these are tough gang members. You see what's happening in Aurora, in Colorado. The mayor is petrified. He's petrified, but the governor is a mess. He doesn't know what the hell. He's a Democrat, liberal. And they're taking over real estate, lots of real estate. The governor doesn't know what to do. And, you know, they want to be politically correct. They don't want to say anything. They're so afraid of saying anything and offending anybody. They have to go in. They have to get them out. But when you look at what's happened in Aurora, in Colorado, it's incredible. And Springfield is unbelievable.
She was everybody's favorite Hindu Indian prosecutor and attorney general and senator. Now she becomes black, but you know, I met her daddy, fine gentleman.
Man, I really don't even talk politics, but I had this conversation with my homeboy last night and it went just like this. This motherfucker gonna tell me, "Oh, I know who you voting for." I said, "Who is that?" He gonna say, "I know you voting for Kamala Harris." Nigga, no the fuck I'm not.
Favorite. And the problem with her being black is Professor Harris says he's Caucasian, mixed Irish and Hindu. He doesn't have any black ancestors, but his Irish ancestors owned a lot of slaves in Jamaica and had them to work on plantation. So if mama is on the birth certificate listed as a Caucasian, daddy says he's a Caucasian Hindu, and has no black ancestors, how did she get to be black?
No, I'm not voting for them motherfuckers. I'm gonna be over here swooping on your ass, nigga. I'm not voting for no goddamn Democrat, nigga. Now why the fuck I wanna vote for somebody just cause they black, they color, they skin, got that? What? Nigga, it's the politics and what they represent to me and all that other bullshit you talking. That don't mean a motherfucking thing to me.
Mistake. On the birth certificate, it lists the mother's race as Caucasian, national origin India, and religion Hindu. For the father, it does not list national origin. It does not list religion. It does not list anything about that, but where it says race, they put national origin in Jamaica by mistake. Now, if you've ever been to Jamaica and you go over to St. Elizabeth Parish, you see all the high, bright, and white that live in Jamaica. So I've got a good friend retired from law enforcement. He has a white wife, blonde haired, blue eyes, but she was born in Jamaica. Her parents were born in Jamaica. One's blonde and blue eyed, the other one's red haired and gray eyed. And they happen to be related to the King of England because they are aristocrats in England, but they were born in Jamaica. It's not unusual. You're not black just because you are from Jamaica, and they have a whole lot of white people that never left, and their ancestors owned a lot of slaves. The Maroons went up into the hill country and got themselves free back in the 1840s, but, you know, other than that, it is what it is in Jamaica. So just because you are from that country does not mean you are of the black race. So the problem is why don't you go get your daddy to give you an affidavit that you have a black ancestor? And since the only possible claim you have is through your great-grandmother, who he says was a Hindu house servant, it just happens to be swarthy, where'd you get your blackness from?
Shit, you crazy enough shit on yourself to think I'm gonna vote for that motherfucker. You got me fucked up. It's gonna be Trump da-dum-dum-dum around this motherfucker. You heard me? That's how I'm coming. I ain't voting for that motherfucker because she black. I wouldn't give a fuck if the bitch was alien green, nigga. I'm not voting for her. She ain't did shit. Motherfuckers, they ain't did shit for black people since black people were black people. What the fuck I look like voting for them motherfuckers? Man, you crazy as hell. Well, y'all need to learn something out here telling you gonna vote color a goddamn color. Nigga, it's two colors, a red one and a blue one, and I'm going with the motherfucking red, nigga. I'm gonna be a blood today, motherfucker. Fuck what you talking about, you ignorant son of a bitches.
There are only two flags. One's red, one's blue. Red's on the right, blue's on the left. Always operate on the right-hand side. Trump 2024. That's the only rational decision that's left. And to you so-called black people, you can't play the race card on me because I'm melanated just like you. Only I know how to think for myself. You're taught what to think. You're a clone of your oppressors. 16 out of 20 years, the Democrats has misled you and done absolutely nothing for you. This video right here is a wake-up call. Why are you accosting me with even the summation of the thought of voting for Kamala Harris and the Democratic Party? If after this video, your decision hasn't altered, then please see a shrink and get help because you need your head checked. This is the KTS Show. I am your host, Kahan Tazadaq. Let's go. Let's get it. Welcome to another episode of the KTS, the Kahan Tazadaq Show. I am your host, Kahan Tazadaq, and the truth will make you mad. This is right knowledge for real. Black people and white liberals, it's imperative that you wake up and snap back to reality. You've been sleepwalking within the Democratic Valley of Dry Bones, and you've been rendered comatose. The left doesn't care about you. They detest
Joseph, Joe, Jim, Jimmy, Jimbo, whatever you want to go by. You want the American people to do what? You want us to continue to fund what? Didn't you just send billions across seas? Go knock on their door. Snatch that check back. What you talking about? You just sent our money over there. We do not have it. You want us to continue to fund what? American. You want the American people to continuously fund hurricane relief when you are taking our tax dollars and giving it to people across seas who could care less about what the hell we got going on over here? None of what real Americans go through affect y'all. That's why y'all can sit on national TV and say stupid stuff like this. Americans to continue to fund the hurricane relief. When y'all sitting over in y'all big ass mansions with y'all feet up eating popcorn, watching fucking House of Cards, trying to be like them for real.
They detest the Constitution and they want to deprive all American people of their freedom. I've served this country and running covert operations overseas, put my life on the line. Not to return to this country and have corrupt politicians deprive us of our liberty and freedom. There's no other country in the world that you could actually have such freedom. If you want to go to combat for a former border czar and vote her into office, someone that's actually allowed and is responsible for a deluge of illegal immigrants coming into this country, rapists, robbers, murderers, then I'll help you pack.
For real. Why don't y'all dig in your personal wallets and your personal purses instead of the American people's wallets and purses asking us to take care of us? Y'all are over there sitting on millions upon millions, and then y'all gonna ask the brokies to fund the brokies.
Because you're not a true American and you don't deserve to be here. So you could be deported with the illegal people that's here. How dare Kamala Harris fund illegal immigrants, give them checks, our tax dollars, and then turn a blind eye and ear to American citizens that's dying, suffering, struggling in Florida, North Carolina, Georgia, South Carolina as a result of hurricane, and then turning would-be rescuers away. The American people have assumed the responsibility that the current administration that you call government has refused to do.
Well, we're gonna give you $750. $750? Oh, you big fucking spender. You big fucking spender. How about this? How about you keep your fucking money? You go enjoy your fucking Julia Roberts, Oprah Winfrey fucking put on a show because you're trying to win an election bullshit, okay? you might want to take your fucking VP and get him some lessons in being an adult and get him some fucking diapers, because he definitely soiled his pants last night, okay? Let us handle this. FEMA, fuck you. America, it's time to step up. We are going to step up, we are going to deliver, and we are going to go into North Carolina, Tennessee, South Carolina, Georgia, Florida, wherever we have to go, because we take care of ours. And I'll tell you right now, you're in New York City, you're a fucking illegal, get your ass out of our hotels. Get your fucking ass out of our hotels. You know what? Fuck it. We don't even want the fucking Roosevelt back. We don't want any of the hotels back, because these dirty, disgusting dirtbags that this fucking administration brought in, they ruined it all to shit. They've ruined it to shit. We'll take Americans into our fucking homes and we'll do what we gotta do. I am disgusted. I am mortified. I am annoyed. Okay, I'm gonna be headed down to North Carolina. I have my SUV. If I can load up, we're gonna load up. Worst case scenario, I gotta rent the U-Haul. Worst case scenario, best case scenario, I gotta rent a couple of Mack trucks. I have CDL drivers. We can get it down there. I got a place to go in Plymouth, North Carolina. They will get it out to Western North Carolina. We are gonna show them that, you know what, the government doesn't give a fuck about you, because they don't even know who the fuck they are right now, okay? Kamala's worried about getting smacked by your fucking alcoholic husband, and Joe Biden basically shit his pants and Jill walked away. But don't worry about it, because you know what? The real fucking Americans are here. We're here for you.
I quote the Declaration of Independence, that whenever any form of government becomes destructive of these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or to abolish it and to institute a new government. Land this foundation on such principles and organizing its powers in such form as to them shall seem most likely to affect the safety and happiness. They haven't done a damn thing for you so-called black people.
After everything I've seen with this presidential election, I have to say this. If you are still voting for the Democratic Party, I'm not saying this because of who you're voting for. I'm not saying this because you're not voting for someone I like. I'm saying this because I genuinely feel that if you are still voting for Kamala Harris after everything we've seen, and this is for the people who actually follow politics and know what the fuck is happening, not the portion of y'all who are just voting against Trump, or the portion of y'all who are voting for her because she's black and you think we need a black president, black woman president. The ones of y'all who truly follow politics, if you are still voting for Kamala Harris after everything that's happening, I just want to say this in the kindest way possible. You are a fucking idiot. Your critical thinking skills are extremely low. You need to go.
So I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to do something that's only going to benefit black people.
Israel has a right to defend itself without any question.
The president and I take very seriously our commitment to Israel and to the people of Israel, to support them, and in particular, to give Israel what it needs to defend itself.
So I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to do something that's only going to benefit black people.
And as long as I'm a United States Senator, I will do everything in my power to ensure broad and bipartisan support for Israel's security and right to self-defense.
So I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to do something that's only going to benefit black people.
We can't deny the significance of vicious, brutal attack that caused the death of 1,200 innocent people, a lot of them young people, women who were brutally assaulted and raped.
Good morning, AIPAC. Good morning. What an honor. I believe the bonds between the United States and Israel are unbreakable.
So I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to do something that's only going to benefit black people.
They haven't done nothing for you. See, the summation of these principles, you know, it becomes the duty of the people to ensure that the administration that has ruined the country for the past 16 out of the past 20 years must be extirpated. To extricate we the people from the onslaught of our liberty. Kamala Harris is very caustic when questioned about the border.
Congressman, that's just not true, right? I mean, you're on the front line. You've spent your whole life in Laredo. The border is not secure, is it?
the border's not secure, without due respect to the VP. We get thousands of people along the border, from 6,000 to 8,000 people a day. So you're talking about almost 4.4 million individuals in 2 years. If you call that secure, I don't know what secure it is.
We have a secure border in that that is a priority for any nation, including ours and our administration.
For 1 minute.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise today to highlight the ongoing, unprecedented disaster that's occurring at our southern border and underscore the need for immediate action. In August, Customs and Border Protection agents encountered 203,597 illegal immigrants at our southern border. That was an increase of 307% compared to the last August of the Trump administration.
We have a secure border in that that is a priority for any nation, including ours.
This also put the U.S. at over 2 million encounters for fiscal year 2022. This is the first time ever that we have eclipsed 2 million in a single fiscal year, and we just have about an entire 1 month to go.
We have a secure border in that that is a priority for any nation, including ours and our administration.
When questioned about how she's going to handle or manage the economy, she's very caustic. The economy. And when it comes to assisting you that are still naive enough to vote for her, she's rather caustic. Nor did I appreciate the caustic tone in Hillary Clinton's voice in a recent interview. They're using a language such as, we need to torch the U.S. Constitution. And I quoted that. That's right. They're using a language stating we need to torch the United States Constitution.
Dan, my name's Jonathan Howard. I'm a member of the Florida State Guard Special Missions Unit. I'm also up here with Aerial Recovery, a nonprofit. I came up here on Sunday with Aerial Recovery before we even got activated. We flew up here and then we got activated, which was great. I have my team up here working as well. Here's the problem. I'm gonna tell you everything that's happening from the ground, what I'm actually seeing, because what they're telling you is complete bullshit on the news and these politicians don't have a fucking clue and they're lying. And I'll say this now, I'll say it at the end of the video. The only thing I need from this video is helicopters. If I have helicopters, I can save lives. Without helicopters, I can't reach these people. It doesn't matter how many chainsaws and trucks I got, I can't get to them. They're 10 miles in, 20 miles, 40 miles in the mountains. There's no way to get with them or even communicate with them. I am literally flying around in a civilian helicopter looking for SOS messages carved in the mud or painted on the ground, and we're dropping down and saving them. What got me fired up about this was yesterday, me and my team did the rescue of that 11-day-year-old baby. And all these government officials and social media, they're showing that video, that pictures and video of that rescue, and claiming that like they have some like government helped with that. And I mean, even USAA, I think it was USAA Today, wrote an article about it saying it was a Florida National Guard that went and got it, like with a helicopter. No, it was me, my buddy Charlie, and a civilian named Zeb with his own personal helicopter out of Wilmington, North Carolina. Like without that civilian, that baby would be dead. And the old lady we went and rescued after that, she'd be dead too because she had 1 day left of oxygen.
Hey y'all, so I'm safe in my house. Our power came on. I have water and I'm so blessed. But the reports that are coming out of these towns in Western North Carolina are horrific. The news is not even coming close to catching the true devastation. There are bodies that are floating down the river, babies. And if this is not a wake-up call that our government is not for us, then I don't know what is. they're everyday citizens who are taking it upon themselves to go and deliver items and things to these people. Anyway, pray for Western North Carolina. And don't believe everything that you're hearing on the news, because they're not. One of my friends in Canada had heard that there were like 200 people missing and maybe 40 dead. Y'all, so much more than that. At the local hospital in Asheville, there are over 900 unidentified bodies. And that was just from 2 days ago. So I'm sure there are more, but there are. People are floating down the river. And if you're able and you can donate or you can get it in the hands of a real person, there were like, I think, 10 different truck drivers who were trying to deliver goods, and they all stopped on the way up there, and every single tire was flashed.
Biden-Harris administration says FEMA does not have enough funds to make it through hurricane season following the allocation of billions in foreign aid. Okay. This is who y'all want to vote for? Remember, I know it's hard for you liberal content creators to remember that there's also liberal people that live in the states that you're so happy got destroyed. I was just there. There were liberals there. Okay. We were giving them food. Water, supplies, etc. This is your girl. This is your grandpapa. They got no more money. But I guarantee if you hop that wall, honey, and you come here, they're going to give you a $5,000 Visa card, put you in a hotel, and give you all a cell phone and all the shit you want.
Well, you're going to have to just excuse my appearance because we have no power. We have no running water, but I'm just so pissed off that I've got to make this clear. We got a notification from TEMA. I'm guessing that's FEMA for Tennessee. I'm not exactly sure. I think it's supposed to be the disaster relief people, but they were like, do not donate your time. We don't want you to donate time unless we ask for you. And we don't want you to donate stuff to other people. You need to just donate money and stuff to us and get your instructions from us and listen to us. What? And then you say, they said yesterday, we don't go into areas that the roads are not easily accessible. What? You are the disaster relief people.
Like $750 fucking dollars. These people have no homes. Mind you, there's still people from Ian, Katrina, Sandy that still don't have homes. $750. Now there's no aid. But I'm sure Zelensky and his boat and his cars and all his fucking lifestyle, I'm sure he's got money though. And I know damn well Kamala Harris has got money. The fuck out of here.
Like, that is your job, to go into the areas that are hit by disaster and provide relief. Not to just go to the easy area and sit and wait for the people that are in the disaster area to be able to come to you. The roads that we do have were cleared by the locals, and you have to have trucks and stuff to be able to get through there. Like, it's just beyond me. So, and you have us all messed up. If you think you're going to come here and bark orders at us and then expect the people just to give you the money and us trust that you're going to try to take care of us when you don't go into areas that are not easily accessible. What? Like, this is Cock County, girl. So, donate to our local churches, because they will make sure that the people that are need it will get it.
$50 to people. All right, it's abject bullshit at this point in time. Kamala Harris comes out and says $750 to people affected by the storm. She doesn't have... Well, who the hell is she? She's the vice president. God knows. Last thing we need is $750 from a fucking DEI hire. It's an insult, man. They're digging people out of the rubble. at this stage? And where's the window licker in chief? Why isn't he making the announcement? Pete Buttigieg says you can't fly drones over their efforts while they're... People are looking for... They're looking for survivors, dude. You got... Where you been, Pete? You been breastfeeding again? You've been MIA, dude. Now I'm hearing reports out of North Carolina that FEMA's finally starting to show up. And you know what they're doing? They're confiscating the goods that have been raised, the people that aren't on the approved list. And you know what? If you defend this government, you're the simp. You are the sycophantal simp that loves a boot on your neck, and you're the reason they put chairs in the corner of the hotel room so you can watch. You're weak.
And you need to just, while we appreciate what help you're trying to provide, I don't think you understood the assignment. Because it's not to just go to one location in hopes that the people in the disaster area can make it to you. So just sit back and watch, and we'll show you how it's done. But we're not going to stop. So please and thank you.
Watch. You're a weak, weak human being. This government hates you. They want us out of the way. This is why we started the Give, Send, Go campaign. You can give to it. Every dollar raised is going to help people in Georgia. Georgia needs a lot of help too, folks. North Carolina's getting the headlines right now. Georgia needs help. So give if you can. Thanks to those who have given already. I love you. God bless you. This government absolutely
Constitution. Sucks. Kamala Harris has an idiosyncrasy that is obvious when she talks. It's quite paradoxical that she claimed to be Indian her entire life, and now suddenly she wants to be black since she's running for the president. Black people really need to wake up and realize that you've been beguiled, beleaguered by this woman and the entire Democratic Party since slavery, since their development of slavery. See, I will argue that black people are suffering from Stockholm Syndrome by continuing to vote for the oppressors, the Democratic Party, who's always oppressed black people, because obviously you're suffering from post-traumatic slave syndrome. And it's been passed down from generation to generation. Because you're fighting those that's attempting to liberate your thinking. And you're fighting for your oppressors.
This morning, I'm dead ass pissed the fuck off. As a recent hurricane survivor, as somebody who's been without lights for 6 days, I am pissed off the fact that I can hear Joe Biden say, we need American people to come together to help the recent hurricane survivors. Why the fuck we got to come together to help ourselves? We didn't have to come together when y'all sent $30 billion to the Ukraine. We didn't have to come together then. So why we got to help? Why we got to come together to help ourselves now? We got to come together to help ourselves because y'all don't give a fuck about us. And y'all can't see that. Y'all love to say they for the people. How they for the people? She asking for donations while Trump out here giving $25 million to help us. Yeah, like, what part of this do y'all not understand? Y'all put so much faith in this old-ass man and this Jezebel-ass lady when constantly they show us that they do not give a fuck about us.
Like Kamala Harris and the Democrats. You're unable to identify with your conditions because you're in a comatose-like state from psychological engineering. So I surmise you call me a racist. I'm melanated. Right? So I surmise you call me a sellout. Because I've called you out for complaining about how racist Mr. Trump is. Because you want to continue to eliminate the responsibility to provide for yourself. You've had an opportunity, the same opportunities that I've had. Truthfully, I came from the bottom. No one's actually ever given me anything. I had to earn it. I had to fight for it. I had to strive for it. I had to work for it. I had to burn the midnight oil for it. I didn't come from the silver spoon culture or community. Fuck you. Get up and assume some responsibility and do it for yourself. Do it for yourself. Why are you accosting those of us that's attempting to
liberate. And this is another prime example of them showing that they just don't give a damn about us. Yes, I can speak on this. Yes, I'm experiencing it myself. So y'all can't say a damn thing about it. Then y'all love to touch on the fact and say something about Heritage, Project 2025. But guess what? The trustee of the Heritage Foundation, which is the foundation that presented Project 2025, why they endorsing Kamala now? Why they endorsing Kamala now? So that's what she's standing for. She ain't nothing but a chair hopper. And she not for the people. And y'all can't see that. I see it more than ever now. They don't give a fuck about us. These folks left us to fend for ourselves and asked us to get the money for ourselves when they sending all the money to these other countries. What part of that makes sense to y'all? Because I don't get it. Make it make sense to me, because y'all going to say something. I'm rage baiting or something. Make it make sense, because I just need to know.
That's attempting to liberate your thinking. That's rhetorical, because I know why. You vote for Kamala, who's exacerbating the importance of funding these illegal immigrants, but's only willing to give $750 to the American citizens that has just...
If we can just get Trump in jail and get rid of all of MAGA, staff the Supreme Court, ban voter ID, get rid of the Electoral College, and censor free speech, we can save democracy. That's what a lot of you fucking liberals sound like nowadays. And I'm not talking about older liberals from the 60s and 70s. I'm talking about the multicolored hair ones that look like Batman villains out of Gotham fucking City. First off, we're not a democracy, so fucking jot that down. We are a constitutional republic. We the people. Which means that we are a republic that is governed by the Constitution, which is a foundational legal document that gives the framework for limitations of the government, and more importantly, protects individual rights. Anybody who's ever been to fucking school knows that you put your hand on your heart and you say, I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, not the fucking democracy for which it stands. It's crazy how fucking crazy the world is right now, and it's only fucking getting worse, so hope you're ready.
Uh-oh, Nobel Prize-winning economist here to tell us how great the economy is. I certainly wonder how the residents of Asheville, North Carolina must be feeling right now with no access to power or water or communication with the outside world. I wonder how enthusiastic they are about the economy right now. I wonder how enthusiastic the residents of the South Bronx must be feeling about the economy. Hey, maybe North Carolina should rename itself Israel so it'll get $20 billion in aid. Or maybe Ukraine so it can get $300 billion in aid. Maybe the South Bronx should do the same thing. I mean, I'm sure the economy is great for smug liberals like yourself who make $5 million and are worth $5 million. I'm sure the economy must be great for all you smug journalists, economists. All of you must be having a great time with the economy when most people can't even pay for basic necessities, for people who are getting evicted because they can't pay their rent. Because over in the South Bronx, just a few miles away from here, there are portions...
That has just actually been devastated by Hurricane Helene. That's atrocious. That's not an insult. That's an assault on our intelligence. She's so didactic when she speaks to aid the American. But with the illegals, she's all for it. I mean, if you can't see this, then you really need to get your head checked. There's definitely something wrong if you can't see this. And if you could actually raise your hand to press a keyboard button or complete a voter's ballot and still vote for this woman, then you really need to get your head checked.
Because there's buildings that are literally collapsing, and I'm supposed to give a shit about the stock market. You want to know why the presidential election is tied right now? Because our money is being sent to Israel and Ukraine. So so that they can continue to bomb innocent women and children. You think that's a great economy? I'm sure Israel, with their free health care, is having a great time with American taxpayer money. Hey, is anyone here going to talk about the fact that we could be in war with Iran in a few days? Or do we need to focus on the S&P 500? Is that what actually...
So if Hezbollah killed Netanyahu, would we say, oh yeah, that's normal? So when Israel was trying to kill Nasrallah, that's totally normal. When Israel tried to kill every Hamas leader, that's normal. So if they kill Israeli leaders in their entire cabinet, just like Israel's doing right now, that should be normal, right? No, American media will say, dirty, Muslim, savage, terrorist, right? When Israel does it, they're like, moral army, great, wonderful. Here's money, here's 26 billion. Americans, shut up and get them more money. 26 billion isn't enough. They sent 8.7 billion to this monster, this fascist, evil terrorist just yesterday. I'm sick of it. How many more people is he going to murder with our money? Those are facts.
So that what actually matters? The S&P 500, when most people may not even be alive here in a few days just because we're on the verge of nuclear war. Hey, listen to me, Mr. Krugman. Your degree is worthless. You might as well use it as paperweight because it means nothing. I hope you enjoy the dead children that the economy is powering. Our economy is definitely very powerful right now. All that stock market money goes to the military complex so that more innocent women and children are dead. And fuck off with the New York Times, the liberal apologists for war and genocide. You all fucking suck. People need to wake up right now.
Because there's definitely something wrong with you. And though I'm trying to be as... what's the word that I'm searching for? In a cautious as possible. You people still vote Democrats. Hereafter. And if you do, you really need to get that mental evaluation because you're all sick. It gets worse. Biden and Kamala says that they have no money to fund the hurricane victims. We have no more hurricane funds. They're all exhausted because we used it on the immigrants. They're not immigrants. They're friggin' illegals. Are you really voting for that lady? Can someone please tell me this is a joke? Giggle, giggle. Please tell me that this is a joke. Hurricane Elena. Tennessee resident says Tennessee FEMA is sending out text messages telling everyone, do not help their neighbors that are in need. Messages saying, and I quote, we don't want you to donate stuff to other people. You need to just donate money and stuff to us and get your instructions from us and listen to us, end of quote. They were like, don't donate your time. If you think you're going to come here and block orders at us and then expect the people to just give you money and the trust you, then you're delusional. A woman in Western North Carolina was in tears. She recounts the horrific sights of seeing babies' bodies floating down the rivers. Forgive me for being very graphic, but I have to paint that imagery in your mind so you can see how atrocious this is and this administration really is. And they don't give a darn about you. With deep emotions, this woman warns the nation that this is a wake-up call, and I contend that she's correct. Her message is clear. Trust those on the ground, not the media that continues to lie. On Israel. What do you call this? I have a question, is this what Zionism looks like?
Why don't you get kidnapped by them in Gaza and see if people come and save you? Because we should have a ceasefire and negotiate with terrorists. They're just going to say, you stop bombing us, we'll stop bombing you. Here, take them back. Yeah, they'll just stay here. Take them back. That's because of Hamas, not because of Israel or the Jews.
True.
You think that we deserve
Israel controls whether they have water, whether they have electricity.
No, 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 we generously give them water. We generously give them electricity.
It's their land, my dear.
They have access to it.
It's their land that was taken from them.
It's not their land. Jesus was a Jew. Do you know that? He was born there. The Jews were there.
And don't you black people ever forget one thing. The man that helped Jesus carry that cross was a black man. And don't ever forget another thing. Jesus belongs to Africa as much as he does to Europe and Asia. He was born in that part of the world that touches Africa and Asia and Europe, and Jesus was not a white man like me, nor was he as black as some of you. We don't know what the color of his skin, but it must have been a dark color like the people of his day, because he was a man like them.
Now, Billy Graham said, well, no one knows his color, but the Bible gives a description. John the Revelator says that his hair was white and woolly, and his feet was like brass if it was burned in the oven. If you burn anything, what color does it turn? Yeah, that's rhetorical. You know the answer.
Are you kidding? In 1948,
there were no
Palestinians. No, there Palestine were Arabs there. Palestine
was
never a state.
What was the increase in
Arab
numbers?
Are you kidding? Do you not know your history?
What was the increase in the number of Arabs in Palestine? He doesn't know the history. I know that there's over 400 Palestinian villages that were destroyed in 1948, what's called the Nakba. Indigenous people. So should we all be kidnapped and tortured, our babies put in an oven, because we took it from the Native Americans?
But yet you're living here. I think we should torture you and your family. Let's cut open your stomach, take out your fetus and throw it in an oven and then smell it while they torture you and cut off your body parts and rape you. Make you naked and drag you through the street.
I just wish your kids were going to be there.
Yeah, you are fucking so stupid.
I wish they will rape you alive. They will kill you. And if your mother will be alive, they will send the video for your mother to see how you burn. That's what I wish. And this is, if this is okay for you, so I don't know what you made from.
To say, to wish that
it's terrible. It's terrible that people had it.
I know.
People burned alive.
And it's terrible.
The mother watch it on TV,
bomb,
on the video,
you know,
on the media.
You know what it bombs?
They film it.
It burns people alive.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's only one name I have to put out there for you to have horror in your hearts. And that's Hind Rajab, a six-year-old girl who was in the car with her relatives. The machine gun bullets ripped through the car, fired by the Israelis, killing her family, leaving her and her 15-year-old relative cousin alive but wounded. They picked up the phone and they called for help. Within minutes, the machine guns opened up again and killed her 15-year-old cousin, leaving a six-year-old girl alone with dead relatives on the phone, begging for help, pleading for help, crying for help. They tried to send help. They sent two paramedics, very brave men, who went out there from the Red Crescent Society. They cleared the path. They got approval from the Israelis to go there and rescue this six-year-old girl. They got within sight, 50 meters away. They said, we see her. We see the car. They got out of the ambulance, and they were immediately gunned down by the Israelis. Murdered. Their crime, trying to rescue a six-year-old girl. She's on the phone begging for help. Please help me. Please come to me. A six-year-old girl pleading for help. And what did the Israelis do? The tanks are coming closer, she said. I'm afraid. The tanks are coming closer. The lady on the other end had her pray, had her recert verses from the Quran. And then the machine guns opened up for a last time. And they murdered Hind Rajab.
All you need is one name. And yet I can give you 40,000 to 190,000 names of Palestinian civilians who have been murdered in Gaza by the Israelis. Their crime, wanting to have a homeland, wanting the same thing we want, a place we can call our own, a place we say, this is my home. This is where I will raise my family. This is where future generations will learn to live in peace with their neighbors. But no, the Israelis don't want to live in peace. The Israelis dream of something. And when I say Israelis, I'm speaking of Zionist people. I'm not speaking of Jews. I'm speaking of Zionists. The Jewish faith is a faith of God. We are not here to speak ill of the Jewish faith. We're not here to speak ill of any religion. We're here to speak ill of the murder in the hearts of those who will steal the land of others so that they can prosper while suppressing the ambitions, the desires, the hopes and dreams of millions of people who are innocent.
Ceasefire is a gift to Hamas.
Shame on you!
Silence is terrible.
Shame on you, you woman!
You don't know nothing! You know over 4,000 children have been killed?
Are you okay? They rape women, they burn them alive?
First of all, they didn't rape
you. Are you okay? They didn't rape you?
No.
They didn't. Why don't you go to Gaza?
Why
don't you go to Gaza to live there? Why don't you go there? Why don't you go there?
So if Hezbollah killed Netanyahu, would we say, oh yeah, that's normal? So when Israel was trying to kill Nasrallah, that's totally normal. When Israel tried to kill every Hamas leader, that's normal. So if they kill Israeli leaders in their entire cabinet, just like Israel's doing right now, that should be normal, right? No, American media will say, dirty, Muslim, savage, terrorist, right? When Israel does it, they're like, moral army, great, wonderful. Here's money, here's 26 billion. Americans, shut up and get them more money. 26 billion isn't enough. They sent 8.7 billion to this monster, this fascist, evil terrorist just yesterday. I'm sick of it. How many more people is he going to murder with our money? Those are facts.
Uneducated is being poorly educated, and you exemplify that.
Let's be very clear.
My ass, your ass. You don't know nothing.
Peace and love. Let's all live together.
Let's be very clear from the river.
AIPAC spends $2 to $3 million a year lobbying Congress on behalf of Israel and promoting Zionist causes. And it frequently writes legislation for Congress. The American Israel Education Foundation spends millions of dollars annually on paid trips to Israel for members of Congress. The Anti-Defamation League, ADL, spends millions of dollars annually spying on Americans who are critical of Israel. The International Fellowship of Christian and Jews uses a $100 million annual revenue stream to promote Israel Zionism. The Central Fund of Israel uses a $20 million revenue stream promoting Israeli settlements in Palestine. Christians United for Israel uses a $7 million annual budget to lobby members of Congress on behalf of Zionist causes. The Washington Institute for Near East Policy, Simon Wiesenthal Center, Israel Project, Friends of Israeli Defense Forces, Women's Zionist Organizations of America, the Jewish Agency for Israel, American Friends of Likud, American Israel Cooperative Enterprise, the Israel Allies Foundation, the Jewish Policy Center, etc., etc., etc.
سمو الدولة تؤكد المملكة رفضها القاطع لاستمرار العدوان والاحتلال والتهجير القسري لسكان غزة كما تؤكد تحميل سلطات الاحتلال مسؤولية الجرائم المرتكبة بحق الشعب الفلسطيني ومقدراته وإننا على يقين بأن السبيل الوحيد لتحقيق الأمن والسلام والاستقرار في المنطقة هو إنهاء الاحتلال والحصار والاستيطان وحصول الشعب الفلسطيني على حقوقه المشروعة وإقامة دولته المستقلة بحدود 67 وعاصمتها القدس الشرقية وهو ما يضمن استدامة الأمن واستقرار المنطقة ودولها والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Americans are waking up to the A, as they say it, APAC, Hurricane Helene victims, while sending billions to fund the Ukraine war. Kamala Harris gave $750 to American victims of Hurricane Helene. Are you people really going to vote for this woman? Are you really that delusional? You can't be that naive. Someone please tell me that this is a joke. Stop playing the race card, calling Mr. Trump a racist. And you black people, you really need to wake up. You've been bamboozled far too long. Then it's with the P. Diddy. Apparently a lot of others are going to go down with P. Diddy. P. Diddy right now is in jail on a suicide watch. Can you imagine going from such luxurious situations to in a cell?
Will drop very soon. Since the day Diddy was indicted for sex trafficking and racketeering, we've been warning you he's just the tip of the iceberg. Today we're being told a list of Diddy's accomplices will drop very soon. Powerhouse attorney Tony Busby just announced that more than 100 people are filing lawsuits against Diddy and others for sexual abuse. 24 of the victims are minors, one of them as young as 9 years old. Diddy allegedly used the promise of a record deal to lure that young victim to his recording studio, where the child was assaulted by Diddy and several others. Diddy's team says the allegations are meritless, but Busby says his upcoming lawsuits will be naming names.
The day will come when we will name names other than Sean Combs, and there's a lot of names. The names that we're going to name, assuming that our investigators confirm and corroborate what we've been told, are names that will shock you. They already know.
He's got everybody on tape. They all know it.
For those who were never at these freak-off parties, what were they like?
See, this is the thing. Everything that I'm about to say to you is not my first-hand knowledge. It is my first-hand witness account experience. I was a sex worker. I was a dominatrix before I got my record deal. That's how I know how the dark world and the sex world and the entertainment world run hand in hand. That's why the movie Blink Twice is so important. Salute to Zoe Kravitz. The sex workers that I have worked with throughout the years and continue to work with even to this day have worn hidden cameras. I have my own tape. I've seen what they do. The ritualistic behaviors, the drugging, putting girls in the suitcases, dumping them in alleyways. It's horrifying. And it's all done under the protection of, this is going to be paid off. There's another NDA. This is going to be, it's terrible.
Shock you. They already know who they are. And I'm talking here about not just the cowardly, but complicit bystanders. That is, those people that we know watched this behavior occur and did nothing. And I'm talking about the people that participated, encouraged it, egged it on. They know who they are. These defendants will not only include individuals, but would also include corporate entities who ultimately profited off of this culture and behavior. I'm looking at banks, pharmaceutical companies, hotels.
This string of lawsuits could shift.
It seems to have been something that people, a lot of people knew about, but people were simply too scared to talk about.
Everyone knows. And every person that's sitting there trying to act surprised knows very well. The whole point of this, like Cat Williams said when he sat with Shay Shay earlier this year, the whole point of this is for them in a coordinated effort to pretend like none of it is real for the public's perception. But everyone knows what's going on, and it's been going on for years. It's been going on before Diddy. See, people keep looking at him like he's the Sputnik that came out of nowhere. This is someone who was designed to be what he is. We got to stop making ditties. And if we're going to do that, then we got to go back. We got to go back to even further, the mentors of these people. Because Diddy was taught how to do what he does systematically. And Clive Davis has been his greatest teacher.
So? Attorney Tony Busby just announced that 120 people are filing lawsuits against Diddy and others for sexual abuse. Some of these children were as young as 9 years of age. A lot of your celebrities are going to fall. A lot of bankers are going to fall. A lot of corporate entities are going to fall. These were satanic rituals, guys. The truth will be exposed. I don't want to say names, but hey, Mr. Carter, where have you been? And your woman. It's going to start to roll downhill now.
Off of this culture and behavior. I'm looking at banks, pharmaceutical companies, hotels.
This string of lawsuits could shake up the top levels of corporate America and Hollywood. Another lawyer says some of Diddy's secret sex tapes are being shopped around. The tape features an A-list celebrity who doesn't seem to realize they were being recorded. Tony Busby is one of the attorneys representing over 120 Diddy accusers. Well, Counselor, thank you for taking this case. This is very important, and we need justice served, especially now that we're hearing there's a victim as young as 9 years old. Are you kidding me?
9, 12, 13, 14, 15. We're talking about 25 people so far out of 120 cases that we intend to file. I would expect there'll be a lot more cases than that. Let's not forget, we're talking about behavior that took place over more than 25 years all over the United States, but primarily in New York, California, and Miami.
And some of these names that I guess will be coming out, who allegedly aided and abetted Diddy in his twisted little escapades, are these names that I would know, that people would recognize? How high is this going up?
Certainly names that you would recognize. And let's think about the kind of people that would be involved in this. People that would be in the room, that would be facilitating this, egging this kind of thing on, encouraging this, participating, venues that were participating, sponsors, hotels, banks. Let's remember that a lot of people were being flown in from across the country and paid in cash. Obviously, that cash had to come somewhere. There had to be some explanation for taking out that much cash from the bank. We already know that there were a lot of drugs in play. So there are many facets of this. There are many people involved. There are many entities involved. And you know, the ones that really irk me, you know, there's been a lot of focus on, well, who are the celebrities? Who are the celebrities? What I'm more focused on, I mean, obviously, to the extent there's a celebrity that it occurred at their house or that they were involved or participated, they will certainly be named. But what really irks me are those who profited off of this culture that was created and that just essentially ruined hundreds of lives.
Jugger White has revealed chilling details about Diddy's notorious satanic rituals that he was calling the freak off, but she said it was taught to Diddy. It's been going on for decades, as we know. But they, when we speak these things, they want the general public to think that we're deranged.
Well, because the Me Too movement was a ruse. It was a setup. It was a scam. I'm saying that now, publicly. Dream Hampton spearheaded the Surviving R. Kelly campaign, which fueled the Me Too campaign. And that was all funded by Sean Carter to make sure that Robert Kelly went to jail. Get his lick back. Why is nobody understanding that Dream Hampton was being financed and ran by Sean Carter? They were able to go and get all of these witnesses because he was there with Robert Kelly. How does Jay-Z sit down with Gayle King and she not ask him one question about the intersection between him and Aaliyah and Robert Kelly? This is insane that people keep refusing to see what's right there. If the Me Too movement were real, why aren't they speaking now? They've also been very quiet in this time of the diddler's downfall.
Jaguar.
Guess they're on vacation.
If this goes to court, Jaguar, do you think the world is going to be shocked by what comes out?
Oh, absolutely. I just don't know why they are. It's been happening in front of everyone's faces for decades.
Let y'all soaking in for a minute. Now if you got blood in the street, this is not a physical life we living in. This is a spiritual war. If you killing spirits, you gonna die in one, huh?
Come on.
If you got blood in the street, homie, you gonna leave here in the same way you left blood in the street. You can't sneak out here with counsel. You die counsel. No, you ain't gonna leave here with your sugar, your leg cut off with diabetic. No. You got blood in the street. A lot of people say you can't choose how you leave here. Yeah, you can. The way you live is how you leave. The way you live is how you leave. You understand me? You don't got a choice, but
God, man.
God, I know. God got a map for you. You just got to get where you're going.
So what I want to do is... Yes.
See, you supposed to. He think he ain't?
Yeah.
And guess what? Man, hey. Leave here. Yeah, you can. The way you live is how you leave. The way you live is how you leave. Talk to me.
P. Diddy, he got put on suicide watch.
Oh, you supposed to?
Yes.
See, you supposed to. He think he ain't?
Yeah.
And guess what? Man, hey, Diddy. Hey, ain't no time for no puff parties.
How do you feel? How does Percy feel he's adjusting to being a billionaire living in a mansion next day you behind that 6x10 or whatever size they may give him?
I'm sorry. But, I'm on the opposite side of the fence. I'm the one that love to see Diddy coming. I'm going to break his ass. Hey, what's up? What's up? You know what your new number is, don't you? You know what your new number is, don't you? 112. Boys. Yeah, I say that to say the people that you messed over in life, it'll come back to you.
For decades.
How many victims?
What's the difference between me and Judy Garland? Social media.
How many victims?
There was none for her.
How many victims potentially do you think there could be?
Thousands. Thousands. I've talked to hundreds that I deal with still myself. I have 3 victims right now who are willing to give testimony about not only what Mr. Carter has done to them, but his wife as well. They're a nasty little couple. They do nasty things.
Now, which deranged is this perverted modern society? That's what's deranged. Where people walk around with a rainbow coalition flag and they look down at their sexual organs and can't determine what sex they are, yet they get rewarded so many rights. That's what's deranged. That a country that claims to grow up and exist on Judeo-Christian principles make it illegal to even mention the Bible. Yeah, we know who your God is. It's the God of the underworld. People, you better wake up. And wake up now. Jay-Z, he might be next to take that L. It's coming, you. It's all downhill from here. Stay tuned. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe. Like, share, subscribe. This is where the truth is told. And BS, yeah, runs a marathon that's exhausting. You will fall out of this race if you're evil, you're wicked, and you're corrupt. So over here, the truth of the Most High is going to stand in the end. And you should know the truth, and the truth will make you mad. Then, make you free. But I surmise many of you will never get over your anger.